Dear Kane, please come to Sleepy Hollow to investigate the mysterious Headless Horseman case. I've heard a lot about your past success, and our city needs a constable like you. Moreover, this is your hometown, so I'm sure the locals will give you a warm welcome. Sincerely, Katrine.
What are these people gossiping about? I'd better grab my constable's orders and listen to them. What are these people gossiping about? What are these people gossiping about?
How awful. Who would want to kill a simple chronicler? He didn't have any enemies, and his only friends were books and quills.
Maybe he learned something he wasn't supposed to. It could have been about the witches. He did spend a lot of time in the old archives.
Is it true that witches have returned with the Headless Horsemen? My goodness. I hoped I'd never heard the sound of those horseshoes again.
There's no evidence except for the Chronicle's blood. They say the horseman takes the heads of his victims as trophies. Can you believe that? Kane, I'm here.
I'm so glad you've arrived. Did you see how many people are in the square? We're all shocked by the latest murder. Please, could you examine the corpse before the local police arrive? They'll only complicate everything. Here, I found this near the body.
I'm Mr. Farvik. I've heard about your investigations in New York, but I'd hoped I'd never see you in my town again. Mind your business, and don't even think of coming near my daughter, Catrin. What's done is done. Don't stir up the past. Catrin, go home. Sheriff McCollins will keep an eye on you. Mr. Farvik, allow me to accompany you to the hotel.
Good evening. I'm Judge Barrett. You must be Mr. Varick. I'm so glad a competent constable has finally arrived to help us with the murder case. We've prepared our best room for you. I'll see you later.
I'm sorry I was so harsh with you in the square. The residents have gone wild since the latest murder, and I've become anxious. I have a lot of responsibility on my shoulders as the mayor. Here, I took the liberty of ordering you some warm tea. Please, drink it. It was cold outside.
The fire's none of my business. The mayor told me to keep an eye on you, and that's exactly what I plan to do. Don't worry. The firemen must be on the way there. Ah, I forgot to give you a letter from Judge Barrett. Here, read it.
Thank you.
need to put out the fire before it spreads! I hope Cain didn't inhale too much smoke. I'll try bringing him back to his senses.
Thank you for bringing me around, Catrin. It seems the tea your father prepared for me had a soporific effect. Someone must have set my room on fire while I was asleep. The arsonist might have left some evidence. Please, could you help me? I'll search this room, and you can examine the surrounding area. Here, this may be useful.
It's Father's cufflink. But how did it get here? Was that the Headless Horseman? Where is everyone?
Look, isn't that Catrin Van Tassel?
Shh! The mayor told us to keep a low profile.
Kane was right. Everything was planned. Thank goodness I noticed the fire. We have the same flammable liquid in our house. It's quite expensive, so not many people buy it. Isn't that my father's pipe? Maybe he stayed in this room before and left it here?
I can't be certain, but it seems that your father tried to burn the room and kill me. I'm not in a position to judge, but the evidence proves he was involved. We should go to your house. I must talk to Mayor Van Tassel.
Good evening, sir. I'm Sheriff McCollins. The mayor wants to see his daughter at the town hall. Please, stay here and wait for the guards. I was told someone set your room on fire, but since you were alone, you're the main suspect.
Let me go! He's not to blame! It was arson, and you need to investigate!
Thank you.
stay here on patrol. Everyone should be home by now, so don't let anyone loiter around here.
I won't come with you. I know everything. I can't believe my own father attempted to murder someone.
Thank you.
Why did you leave your room and go to the hotel? I ordered you to stay away from Mr. Varvik.
I found your pipe and cufflink in the burned room. You wanted to kill Kane. And I don't want anything to do with a father like you. I'm leaving town right now.
Mr. Varrick, what is going on? I must detain you until we can clear things up. Oh, please, don't be scared of me, darling. Your father's death was a terrible accident, and I'm truly sorry for it. This skull, it helps me control the Headless Horseman, and he won't harm you as long as he obeys me. All the Horseman's victims died for a reason. They're all to blame for my mother's death. My mother was a witch, and I inherited a lot from her. Every night, I hear the witch's voices ordering me to avenge their deaths. But you, Catherine, are the only thing I love in this town. I have to leave you in my secret shelter while I dispense real justice. I urge you not to do anything reckless.
Thank you. creatures almost always give birth to daughters. Your mother was lucky to have a son. She was a kind healer, and she wanted you to continue her ways. She really hoped that you would use your magic for good, not for murder. It hurts me to see the evil glow in your eyes. Your mother may have been killed, but she would still never want to be avenged at the cost of people's lives.
Oh, Priscilla, now I regret sparing you. I thought as a persecuted witch you'd understand my anger. But it's no matter. Today I will move forward with my plans and won't show mercy to any of those narrow-minded locals. You can't stop me.
Spellbook from my bag and get rid of these vines. Please help me. Take the spellbook from my bag and get rid of these vines.
Thank you.
The vines are gone!
Thank you. I'm Priscilla, a reclusive local witch. Most people don't know I exist. Otherwise, they would have killed me a long time ago. The witches of the Sleepy Hollow were persecuted for many years. Barrett is the son of the most powerful witch healer I've ever known. I had hoped he would help me. I wanted him to learn magic and show people that it can be used for good, that it can heal people and bring joy. But he didn't use his knowledge to help the forest witches come to terms with the locals. He wields it to get revenge for his mother's murder. Instead of becoming a mediator, he's turned into an executioner. Please stop him before he kills everyone in Sleepy Hollow. Explore the forest. I often leave useful things here. This will help. I'll go to the other witches in the forest. We must devise a way to stop Barrett.
Kane Varvik is accused of murder of Sleepy Hollow's mayor, Baltus Van Tassel. For his crime, he is sentenced to death. The murder was planned. Mr. Varvik has long been in love with the mayor's daughter, Catherine. Baltus Van Tassel understood that this trickster was unworthy of his beautiful daughter. Varvik came to our town not to help the police get rid of the horseman, but to kill Mr. Van Tassel and take his daughter to New York. Look at these papers. They say I made a request to the New York Police Department. They're counterfeit. Dear citizens, this man will get what he deserves. The executioner will arrive soon.
Catherine? My love. Oh, I'm so glad to see you safe and sound. Everything Barrett just said is complete nonsense. And I had no intention of killing your father. Do you believe me? What? Barrett is going to kill everyone in town to avenge his mother's death. We must stop him. Please, cut the ropes and free me.
The Headless Horseman committed all the murders, but Barrett controls him with the skull he's always carrying. If we steal the skull, Barrett won't be able to order the horseman to do anything. Please, help me! Please! Thank you. We've lost some time, but we still have a chance to stop Barrett. We should go to his manor. Barrett lives downtown in Sleepy Hollow. I hope we'll find some information about the Headless Horseman there. The downtown area must be closed for the night, so we'll have to find a way to sneak in there. Take this. A handkerchief is always useful.
Thank you. Trouble that your death won't raise any questions.
Don't move. Seems my traps weren't good enough. The High Society of Sleepy Hollow has finally found me.
You're awake. You were hurt in the explosion, but my herbs healed you. I returned from the forest when I saw you. On the river shore. Judge Barrett has taken his skills with magic too far. Everything good that his mother passed on to him has disappeared.
Witch! Burn the witch!
Barrett must have told them that I control the Headless Horseman. The entire town is against me. Please, we must leave before the crowd starts to act out. There's a secret passage in the fireplace. Open it. The blame for all of this falls on my shoulders as well. I taught Barret magic, but I never imagined that he'd use it for such evil purposes. Return the skull to the Headless Horseman. It's the only way to make Barret lose control over him. Hurry, I'll distract the crowd and the police. Here, this will help you.
Right on time, Mr. Varvik. I knew you'd come.
Now that I know the whole story, I'm sorry I acted so impulsively. I thought you were in cahoots with Judge Barrett. I suspected he was somehow involved in dark wizardry and the murders of the townspeople for a long time. Barrett wanted to arrest me for delivering fish to the poor locals from the neighboring city. He said it was illegal, but I couldn't stand by and watch people starve. Now I have to stay in hiding. I want to go to another town, but my boat is broken. If you help me repair it, I'll tell you how to get inside Barrett's house. I used to bring food supplies to his basement, and I have an inlay that will help you sneak up there. Thank you for your help. Now I can leave this gloomy place and start a new life somewhere else with my relatives. I heard a lot about that new constable from New York. I'm sure that together you'll manage to stop Judge Barrett and make him pay for everything he's done. I have to go, but I hope we'll meet again one day. Here, this will help you open the door to the basement. Goodbye, Katrin.
Katrin!
You disobeyed me? Maybe you're not as loyal and obedient as I thought. I can't get my hands dirty by murdering you, so I'll leave the job to the horsemen. Can't lose control of the horseman.
Katrin, I'm amazed by your bravery. If it wasn't for you, I could never have dealt with the Headless Horseman and his master. You deserve a better life than one in Sleepy Hollow. Will you marry me and go with me to New York?
Oh, Kane! Yes! I've been waiting for this moment all my life.